Sveiki, mėlyje Žalgiris TV žiūrovai, su mumis yra dar vienas labai malonus pašnekovas ir man pačiam labai smagu pristatyti jį, tai yra Grigorijus Chižniakas, Žalgiryje du sezonus žaidęs aukštaugis krepšininkas iš Ukrainos. So, hello Grigorij.
Sveikas kauniečiai, sveikas žalgiriečiai, sveikas.
Štai taip mes pradedame interviu. So, what does it like for you to come back here in Kaunas and to be here in Žalgirio arena with Žalgiris fans?
So, Žalgiris for me is really important. I just can say that Žalgiris for me is the second motherland, you know? I become like, say, like normal human, like in Ukrainian. But I became like real basketball player. I started to real play basketball just from Lithuania. I started playing in Lithuania. It's a really big school, still big school of basketball. And after this, my career is growing up like three, you know.
Yeah. Can I call you Grisha?
No problem.
Okay. So Grisha, what are you doing right now? What are you still involved in basketball?
So now I'm a manager of public relation in BC Budivelnik, so in Kyiv. And now, so sometimes I come in the court to play with some veterans games, like not games, like practice, you know. But for me, it's a big pleasure, and I want to say a big thanks for Žalgiris club to invite me here in the game. And to see this final games, really I miss this finals like Žalgiris to Ritas because I played 2 years in a row with Ritas. I understand that it's different games, different teams, different times, but still I think atmosphere Žalgiris to Ritas, my opinion, is better than Barcelona and Real Madrid, my opinion.
What do you remember the most from those days? Any funny stories, any good games you remember?
I remember almost everything which consists with Žalgiris. I remember fans, I remember the support. For example, tonight when I ordered taxi, I mistake it because I tried to call and go in Sportugalia, you know. And I forgot, no, really, I forgot that, oh, Žalgiris playing in a new arena, more than sorry, say, I go in the Žalgiris arena. So I remember almost everything. I remember my 2 years, it was great years in my career. I remember almost our each game as we did, almost our each final games, you know. It was really nice. It was really nice atmosphere, really nice people still living in Lithuania and working in Žalgiris. So it was really nice time.
So do you get a lot of attention here in Kaunas while you being here?
So Lithuania is a basketball country and Kaunas is really basketball city. As a capital, I think my opinion is capital of basketball. So it's not like a surprise for me. It's good, but I don't pay attention real because I appreciate people, but no, it's not so important now.
When you played in Žalgiris, you were the leader of blocks in EuroLeague in LKL games. What does it mean for you to be leader in blocks?
It's nothing when your team is losing, you know. For me, I try to do my all the best to help team to win, you know. And if my like blocks help, it's no problem. It's really nice. And for me, like statistic, for me, is not important.
Do you still keep in touch with those Žalgiris players you play together here in Kaunas?
For sure. Yesterday I saw Maximo Mark in Akropolis, Paulus and Kunas. He played on our second team, but last season I played in also a game in Venus, so I knew, and I remember all my former teammates. For example, I was really glad for Thomas Masulis with his young team, second team Žalgiris, who played in EuroLeague. I follow in all the results. Žalgiris, my son going now in a Sabonis school. He live here, so I also get some news from him about Žalgiris. But I'm in touch every time in Žalgiris, so no problem. So, even in my heart.
Nice to hear. So talking about your son, what did you choose for him Kaunas? What did you choose Lithuania for him?
Because, how I say before, basketball is the first in Lithuania and a really, really great school. If you just following on the history of Lithuania, history of basketball, a lot of real superstar like Sabonis is unbelievable, like man, like superstar, like Šaras Jasikevičius, who's now the Žalgiris head coach. I can call a lot of names, you know. He's really stars, not even in Lithuania, in Europe, in all over the world. So that's why my son going here in Žalgiris. So now for him is the first dream, first goal to reach a main team of Žalgiris. So I. For me, it's really good because he had a big wishes. He won't do all the best, but we will see. That's why he stay here and try to do all the best like me, probably.
Yeah. As I heard, you also joined Žalgiris Honorary Club, yeah, for those fans this season. Is that true?
Probably we will see. I don't know now exactly, but we will see.
Okay, Grisha, so for the final part of the interview, could you say something in Lithuania for the fans, for everybody who watches this show?
Labai ačiū for, okay, I'll say in English because a little bit nervous and worried. I really appreciate for Žalgiris fans, for Kaunas, for Kauniečiai, Žalgiriečiai. Balta, žalių balta jėga. Žalių balta laimėjom. Žalių balta einam. Ačiū.
Thank you, Grisha. Thank you very much. Thank you.